Plant need leaves for synthesizing sugars by photosynthesis using sunlight and carbon dioxide from the air.
While the roots provide mineral nutrients and water required for this process.
The architecture of the entire plant depends on the ability of the root tips to sense signals from its environment. In this video lecture, we will discuss about plant-microbe interaction in the rhizosphere.
Hunt for the nutrients is not a simple task for the growing roots. It faces many threats every time when it tries to penetrate new region in the soil.
The soil is actually a battlefield comprising fungi, bacteria, and nematodes that lay eggs within the roots. There are also others like earthworms that feed on the roots and few microbes that feed on these nematodes and worms.
How does microbes get to know where the plant is in the soil?
Plant roots release certain chemical molecules in the soil which attract various microbes. These root secretions are called root exudates. They govern the type of microbes that may reside around the plant roots. Root exudates are often divided into two classes of compounds, low molecular weight and high molecular weight organic compounds. When these molecules are sensed by microbes in the vicinity, they migrate towards the root by a phenomena known as chemotaxis. Other than low molecular weight and high molecular weight compounds, the plant root detaches the living cells lining the root cap as a part of front line of defense. In this picture, you can see the fine particles being released from the root tips. The disadvantage is that it attracts harmful herbivores from the vicinity. The region around the roots can be broadly divided into three zones. The rhizoplane is the immediate surface of the roots. The rhizosphere is the soil surrounding the rhizoplane contains microbes influenced by root exudates. The bulk soil is the region which is not influenced by root exudates. There are two types of interaction in the rhizosphere: a positive interaction, b negative interaction. The positive interaction is beneficial for both plant and microbe. Arrow in this figure represents the interaction is bidirectional and the exchange of materials takes place between the two organisms. The bacterial community play role of decomposers, plant growth promoting rhizobacteria or symbionts as in root nodule. Here, there is an exchange of nutrients between the plant and bacteria. The fungal community functions as biocontrol, mycorrhiza or endophytes. Here, fungi provide protection against other fungal pathogen and the plant provides habitat and nutrients. Similarly, roots also release chemicals for interaction with kinds and neighboring plants. Interaction with certain nematodes induce systemic acquired resistance that boost plant immunity. While in negative interaction, the plant is harmed. Bacterial pathogens infect plant roots and in response, roots release antimicrobial compounds to inhibit bacterial growth. Plants release antifungal compounds against fungal pathogens, which release phytotoxins to harm the plant. Plants fight with incompatible neighboring plants using allelochemicals. Nematodes, pests lay eggs in plant roots and scavenge nutrients for which plants release insecticidal compounds. So, how to study the microbes from different root zones? First, collect the bulk soil from unplanted region. Second, plant root is harvested and the rhizosphere soil is collected by normal washing. Third, for separating rhizoplane microbes, the roots are vigorously washed by sonication, which will also release the endophytic microbes. All this soil suspension is processed for identification and isolation of microbes. Finally, a comparative study is performed to identify the microbes unique to each zone. Why to study microbe interactions in rhizosphere? Studies in this area led to the identification and development of microbial consortia to boost agriculture yield. Examples are development of biocontrol agents like trichoderma, phosphate solubilizing bacteria, biofertilizer, vesicular herbicular mycorrhiza, and waste decomposers. Summary: plant root release root exudates which attract microbes. These microbes can be beneficial by providing nutrients or harmful as pathogens. Rhizosphere research has led to the development of various commercial products boosting agriculture yield.
Thank you for watching my video. Subscribe for more videos on plant interactions.